by your nearest friends and family who are here to witness and participate in your marriage. You are joined as well by the thoughts of those who cannot be here and would have loved to share this experience with you. Who has the honor of presenting this to you?
brownie points. Just fine. They don't carry over. For Christ's sakes, they don't last long. And I spent the first part of my marriage trying to earn some brownie points so that I can make things go forward for me. Especially for my wife. Everything seems to work for me. That's how it is. I was in my hop garden the other day. And for those of you that don't know, a hop plant is a vine, the buds of which are used to flavor beer. And they start out as these tiny little shoots, individual shoots. I've got about 35 or 40 individual shoots sprouting out of the ground. Before too long, they start to find a partner. Intertwined and intertangled and really grow together. In fact, that's a good metaphor for marriage in a sense, because what you're really doing is building a life on each other to flourish and to grow. And I love my wife every day a little more than the previous. It truly is a relationship that grows and it's a lot of hard work. It's not always easy. It's not easy to compromise all the time. But I've seen with my parents, and I've seen with my grandparents, that in the end, you wind up with a friend. Your best friend. A friend that nobody can go to, nobody can compare to. And I've got all the faith.
Now we will hear from the handsome crew, Gene.
Bonjour, welcome. I just want to say we're very excited to be a part of this really fabulous event, and we appreciate you being asked to speak and be part of it up here. When Adam asked me to talk about general relational advice, I thought, okay. Just a little background. Again, I'm Adam's dad, actually his favorite dad. Okay. And this is my significant other, Todd Dockin. And we first dated after college for 2 years, and then we went our separate ways. And in the mid-90s, we came back together. So we've actually been together 2 years, and then the second time, 20 years. So after 22 years, we know what the short-term relationship is and the long-term relationship is. So having said that,
we compiled our wisdom of all those years together. We come up with a recommendation of how to maintain the relationship last, and it's in the form of a top 10 list. So with no further ado, let's get on with the top 10 list. Number 10. It's not about accumulating wealth, it's about accumulating memories. So celebrate and share the rare and memorable experiences in your life, like any Chicago Cubs victory.
Number 9, always show respect for each other's personal property. In other words, give your partner a heads up before you throw out their 30-year collection of souvenir plastic beer cups.
Number 8. Settle differences, often it's useful just to agree to disagree. As an old boss of mine used to say, allow me to give you the opportunity to agree with me.
Number 7, never underestimate the power of a glass of wine.
Number 6, it's important to forgive and forget. The good news is, as you get older, the forgetting part comes naturally.
Number 5. Sometimes in order to facilitate the end of a disagreement, it's best to just give in and say, I would agree with you, and then we both agree.
Number 4. The foundation for a solid relationship is full trust and honesty. Well, full trust is good, but really a full trust fund would be even better.
Number 3. This is from a dear friend of ours. You cannot be grateful for what you have. Be grateful for what you have.
Number two, remember that sometimes silence is golden, particularly during Sports Center, 24, The Blacklist, or in some cases, The Bachelor, American Idol, and any Roger Federer tennis match.
So just to recap, accumulate memories, show respect, agree to disagree, forgive and forget, trust and honesty, be grateful, no one can be quiet, drink wine, and finally our number one piece of advice, get married in Paris so your family and friends can have a great vacation.
Salute.
And now we will hear from Robert, grandparent of the bride.
Thank you.
The result in the cavern.
closing thought, The Art of a Good Marriage by Wilfred Arlen Hughes. The little things are the big things. It is never being too old to hold hands. It is remembering to say I love you in this one today. It's never going to seem angry. It is never taking the other for granted. The courtship should not end with the honeymoon.
Come away with me in the night. Come away with me and I will write you a song. Come away with me. Come away where they can't tempt us with their lies. And I want to walk with you on a cloudy day in fields where the yellow grass grows knee high. So won't you try? Come away with me and we'll kiss on a mountain top. Come away with me and I'll never stop loving you. Thank you. while I'm safe there in your arms. So all I ask is for you to come away with me in the night. Come away.